Sri Amar Patnaik. Sri Amar Patnaik.
So this amendment to the Act, which has been brought in, had passed through a standing committee when the bill was initially introduced in 2007. I'd like to refer to the standing committee's report in 2008. One of the recommendations was that the committee does not find any valid reason to limit the role of AERA to these airports and recommends, that is when the limit was only 1.5 lakh million, and recommends that it should regulate all airports used for the operation of commercial flights irrespective of size, ownership. Please, I would like to flag this particular aspect since we are talking about private and government airports. So ownership or throughput of the passengers. So this was the recommendation of the standing committee in 2008. Now, once this has been done, to pass an amendment at this stage to take more airports outside the regulatory regime defies really logic. The second aspect is, once you have certain number of airports under regulatory regime and a large number outside the regulatory regime, you will have a differential structure. Now, when you have such a differential structure, does the government think that in future there will be another regulator to manage those airports which are outside the regulatory framework? For example, those who are coming, let us say, under the private sector. Now, I also have the CAG's performance audit report on the dial. The dial introduced, the bid document did not talk about development fees, but the dial charged the development fees and the government subsequently sanctioned it. This was there in the report. Now, if this could be done by the private operator, how do you regulate such kind of stuff? Since we are inviting, which is welcome, since we are inviting private sector in a large scale into the airport sector, I think it's a good step, but there is a need for a regulator to ensure that the bid provisions need to be also monitored and, in case it is required, revised. I am sure the bid, I understand the concern expressed by honorable member that once you have a bid process, you can't really complicate it by putting it under a regulator. But I'm sure it can be structured in such a manner, because it, you are giving a bid for 30 years, and in some cases 30 plus 30, 60 years in case of dial. So I'm sure it can be put under a regulatory regime. Otherwise, the government, I'm sure, will be faced with a situation of having different structures, at different points of time. More importantly, how can you say that the conflict of interest will be addressed only in certain kind of airports and will remain in the other airports? The main object of the Act is that you will not have a conflict of interest between the Airport Authority of India and the operator, which cannot act both. Now, in this situation, when you are putting certain number of airports under the regulator, you are leaving a large number who are still facing this conflict of interest, which is the AAI. The second point, the third point that I would like to bring out is the definition of the aeronautical services under the OMD, then the Airport Regulatory Authority. I think that should have been addressed, because that was also indicated in the performance audit report. However, considering the fact that Bhubaneswar, which is now under the 15 and 35 lakh airport annual traffic and might graduate into this particular coverage, I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Minister through the Chairman that Honorable CM Oressa had made a request that from Bhubaneswar to Dubai, there should be a direct flight of Air India or some other airlines that would increase the traffic at Bhubaneswar and will come out of this regulatory regime. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Patnaik.